Various ways to lose weight at the gym. If you want to lose weight, working out at the gym is one of the best ways to do it. Learn more about the various ways to lose weight in the gym below. 1. Talk to your doctor to determine a healthy weight loss goal for you. Although many people want to lose weight, not everybody actually needs to. Your doctor will be able to tell you what a healthy weight range would be for you, based on your particular physical characteristics. Use this information to set a healthy weight for yourself that you'd like to reach. For example, if your doctor tells you that a healthy weight range for you would be 150 to 160 pounds, 68 to 73 kilograms, set a goal for yourself to eventually weigh 155 pounds, 70 kilograms. Don't try to lose more than 2 pounds, 0.91 kilograms, a week. This is not only unrealistic for most people, but it also makes you more likely to regain the weight you lost later. Ideally, you should aim to lose 1 pound, 0.45 kilograms, a week overall. 2. Use push-ups, planks, and jogging to assess your fitness level. To test your muscular strength and endurance, perform as many push-ups as you can before you have to stop and rest. See how long you can hold a plank to test your abdominal muscle strength. Finally, time how long it takes you to complete a 1.5 miles, 2.4 kilometers, run to gauge your aerobic fitness. Use the results of these tests to determine how intense your initial workouts at the gym should be. A healthy 25-year-old man should be able to jog 1.5 miles, 2.4 kilometers, in 11 minutes and perform 28 push-ups in a row. A healthy 25-year-old woman should be able to jog 1.5 miles, 2.4 kilometers, in 13 minutes, perform 20 push-ups in a row. Most healthy people should be able to hold a classic front plank for 1 to 2 minutes. Planks are a safer and more effective alternative to crunches or sit-ups for building and gauging abdominal strength. People over or under the age of 25 will have less intense benchmarks for gauging their particular fitness level. 3. Run on the treadmill without holding onto the handles. Running or walking on the treadmill is one of the best ways to burn fat at the gym, since you already know how to walk or run. However, you need to actually bear the brunt of your body weight in order to effectively burn calories. Avoid holding onto the handles while you run, if you can. A good workout to perform on the treadmill is to run at a moderate intensity for about 30 minutes. You may be able to burn fat even more efficiently by varying the intensity of your run over 20 to 30 minutes. This is called interval training. If this workout is too intense for you, decrease your speed to a more comfortable pace. If you want to increase the intensity, try running at a faster speed or at a bit of an incline. You should generally only grasp the handles if you're having trouble staying upright. However, if you are having trouble staying up, you need to get off the treadmill immediately and get help from a member of the gym staff. 4. Perform high-intensity intervals on a stationary bike. Do a couple of minutes of high-speed cycling, followed by a couple of minutes of slower cycling. Repeat this process over the course of a 30-minute workout for an efficient calorie burner. This is an especially useful workout if you suffer from joint pain, since there's less impact on your knees. 5. Swim laps or tread water in the pool if your gym has one. Just treading water is a good workout, since your muscles are constantly fighting against gravity to keep you afloat. For a more intense workout, swim laps at a relatively fast speed for as long as you can. Be sure to change your stroke style every couple of laps. For example, if you just swam 2 laps using a breaststroke, do the next 2 laps with a butterfly stroke. Don't swim as fast as you possibly can, at least not all the time. Just like with running, aim for an intense but tolerable pace that you can sustain for at least 30 minutes, if not an hour. 6. Use the rowing machine to engage most of your body's muscles. Row a set distance, for example, 250 meters, 0.16 miles, as fast as you can, then slow down for 1 minute. Repeat this process over a 30-minute workout period. This is a very good machine for working out your arms and back as well as your leg muscles. 7. Lift heavy weights to build muscle and increase your metabolic rate. Start out with weights that you can lift 8 to 12 times without having to strain too hard. Then, gradually work your way up to heavier weights over the course of several workout sessions. Taking this type of gradual approach will dramatically reduce the risk of injury as you build more and more lean muscle. Although it may seem counterintuitive to build muscle if you're trying to lose weight, the added muscle mass will increase the amount of calories you burn while you're resting. This means you'll burn more fat over time, even as you gain a little extra muscle weight.
If you are interested, please click on the link below the video to watch the full content.